So these dung beetles, they're born into shit. Their mamas feed them shit. Because the mothers were also born into shit. They grew up in shit. They ate shit. They live shit. Shit sustains them.
The beetles are nature's garbage men, and a lot more. They can shift up to 200 times their weight in feces every day. A fresh dropping is cleaned up within 3 minutes. Spread everywhere by the lowly beetles, the nitrogen-rich dung fertilizes the grasslands, helping to sustain millions of animals, and in turn, the entire food chain.
Feed shit to their young, and the young grew up and also eat shit, raise their children in shit, and so on it goes. And at no point does any other beetle say to them, you know, this is shit. It smells bad, it looks bad, and it tastes bad. Because it's all they know. Because they're beetles, and it's all they know. And I think humans can also be shit eaters. I mean, I was once a shit eater myself. I was fed shit by people who loved me, who adored me, who wanted me to be sustained as they had been sustained by shit. But the difference is, at some point, I looked at what was placed in front of me, and I noticed that it smelled bad, it tasted bad. And I refuse to eat anymore.
It is a dream deeply rooted in the American dream. I have a dream that one day this nation will rise up, live out the true meaning of its creed. We hold these truths to be self-evident that all men are created equal.
There are two kinds of Christians. There are those who eat shit that is fed to them. And there are those who supply the shit.
Because I have a dream that my four little children will one day live in a nation where they will not be judged by the color of their skin, but by the content of their character. I have a dream today.
And I think the ones who supply the shit are the ones who have recognized to some degree that shit smells and tastes bad, but I can make a lot of money from supplying it to these people, this market of shit eaters.
I have a dream that one day every valley shall be exalted. Every hill and mountain shall be made low, the rough places will be made plain, and the crooked places will be made straight, and the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all flesh shall see it together. This is our hope. This is the faith that I go back to the South with.
when it's fed to you by a stranger, what does that mean? What is their purpose? What is their intention? Someone who has no knowledge of you, or what is their intention? It is always, always selfish. It is always a selfish intention.
This will be the day. This will be the day when all of God's children be able to sing with new meaning, "My country, tears of thee. We land of liberty, of thee I sing. Land where my fathers died, land of the pilgrim's pride. From every mountainside, let freedom ring. And if America is to be a great nation, this must become true."
It is never, ever, and I can't think of a single instance where it would be fed to you out of love from a stranger.
When we let it ring from every village and every hamlet, from every state and every city, we will be able to speed up that day when all of God's children, black men and white men, Jews and Gentiles, Protestants and Catholics, will be able to join hands and sing in the words of the old Negro spiritual, "Free at last, free at last. Thank God Almighty, we are free at last." One day, down in Alabama, with its vicious racist, with its governor having his lips dripping with the words of interposition and nullification, one day right there in Alabama, little black boys and black girls will be able to join hands with little white boys and white girls as sisters and brothers. I have a dream today.
Relatively speaking, it's better to be a shit shoveler or a shit supplier than it is to be a shit eater. And I guess you could be both. But I think there are other options. There are other things to eat.
With this faith, we will be able to hew out of the mountain of despair a stone of hope. With this faith, we will be able to transform the jangling discords of our nation into a beautiful symphony of brotherhood. With this faith, we will be able to work together, to pray together, to struggle together, to go to jail together, to stand up for freedom together, knowing that we will be free one day.
And I think I've used up all my metaphors.
I still have